And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. We have to head back to the Citadel to go to Bryson's lab to investigate the artifact we found here on this Mojavid, how do you say it? Asteroid mining facility. Calliston Rift. We have uncovered all assets, explored all systems. Good to know. Let's fuel up before we... Do I have fuel here? No fuel? What? Alright, let's head back. Yes, Krogan DMZ at some point. When we're done with all this. One mission at a time. Here, there's not any either. Fuel, that is. Turn to Bryson's lab. Bryson lab. Bloop. B for Bryson. So it did survive. Why couldn't I see it after he detonated that?
We need to shield the artifact they've got here right away.
Oh, I've got
Garno's data. I should be able to accomplish this without difficulty.
Okay. Now what?
Damn thing's been here the whole time. Why weren't we affected?
Perhaps the amount of time spent near the artifact is key. After a certain duration, it affords Leviathan an impressive mind control capability.
Hmm. So I guess it should have been obvious to me. Leviathan uses the artifact to control people. But is Leviathan an ally? He didn't seem too happy about us before.
I'd call it dangerous as hell. Bryson's assistant tried to kill me.
Perhaps Leviathan was controlling him to protect itself, diverting people away from its trail.
It definitely...
Maybe. It just shows we don't know what we're dealing with yet.
Yeah.
Despite the risk, this artifact remains our only link to finding Leviathan.
I love that outfit.
Perhaps we could find more information about it here in the lab.
Agreed. Bryson's team might have turned up something we missed. I'll look around.
Yeah, I was trying to say, it definitely wants us to leave it alone. Here's that head that screams. Data file. Energy emissions tests. So this stuff wasn't here before? What the hell? Artifact P3X118, Hadley Derrick. Initial tests. Artifact tests negative for infrared and ultraviolet emissions. No gamma or X-ray radiation detected. Follow-up tests. Artifact does not react to application of various stimuli. Internal readings inconclusive. No progress in determining age. Guess I stayed here all night finding out that this thing isn't really important. Fell asleep at desk. Conclusion. Artifact is definitely inert and safe. Recommend keeping it here for reference. We should all be near it. Maybe more useful than Leviathan in long run. Recommend we abandon hunt for Leviathan and seek more productive studies. Right, you're being controlled. We should all be near it. It wants them to be near it so it can continue controlling. And it wants them to abandon studies. I don't buy a word of this.
They were testing the artifact for energy emissions.
And found nothing. Still, I recommend leaving it shielded.
As do I. I mean, who knows if that even works.
Bryson's assistant Hadley. Do we have an update on his status?
He is in a vegetative state. The doctors believe it is permanent.
Oh, damn.
But the miners recovered when the artifact was destroyed.
Hadley lost consciousness when he attempted to answer our questions about Leviathan. It may have been a deliberate attempt to silence him permanently.
Right. Well, there's another thing here. There's a microscope.
Anything interesting about the artifact's structure?
It is not constructed of the same compounds used in standard Reaper technology. Beyond that, nothing of relevance.
Scream again for me. You know I love it. Awesome. Can we go outside again? I don't know why I always like to go outside here. I mean, we did find, like, some kind of a weapon add-on here. Oh, I can go in this way. Cool. Let's just check. There's nothing gonna be nothing over here. I don't want to completely skip this side of the lab either. Okay. Spooky music of wonder and stuff. Project information.
Edie, what project was Garneau working on when he found the artifact?
Basilisk.
Got anything on Basilisk?
Several ships, a mythical creature, and a rare mid-tier enemy type in the Galaxy of Fantasy video game. It possesses a gaze attack capable of triggering synced animation kills. Player forms describe it as overpowered.
I meant the project, Edie.
Oh. Then, no.
There's got to be something here on this artifact. What about the server?
Bryson's assistant wiped the office server and destroyed all backups, likely before killing Bryson. However, records show new messages on Bryson's personal comm terminal upstairs.
Could be worth a look.
Definitely. Bloop. Anything else around here before I head upstairs? Nope. Beam me up. Comm terminal over here.
A message from Dr. Bryson's daughter, Anne. According to my records, she worked with her father.
Well, that his daughter, not his wife.
I'm at the dig site in the Pylos Nebula. Project Scarab paid off. I've got another artifact like the one Garneau found. I think it could be affecting people's behavior. You need to shield the one in your office. I tried to warn Garneau, but I can't get through. We've got Reaper scouts coming in toward the main site. I'm heading to the secondary base to grab what research I can.
Ann Bryson was attempting to contact Garneau on the asteroid colony. She seems to know something about the artifact.
She's cute, and she's in trouble.
She sounded worried.
If Reaper forces were approaching, her concern was warranted.
Mm-hmm.
Let's hope we get to her before they do.
She said she was in the Pylos Nebula, working for Project Scarab. That cluster contains several systems. I'll call up the nebula on the galaxy map. We may also search the lab for clues to narrow down her location.
Yeah, gonna do that. I keep hitting J for journal. Damn it. It's also partially because I've been playing Pillars of Eternity again, and you hit J for journal. Ann Bryson is the best source of information about the Leviathan artifact. Search the Pylos Nebula to find her. And also search the lab here for any additional information. Oh, something here.
Does anything in Ann Bryson's work history suggest where she might be?
Nothing relevant.
Task Force Aurora. Current travel requisitions. Project Basilisk. Team Leader, Garneau, Alex. Transport MSV Kirkwall. Project Scarab. Team Leader, Bryson, and MSV Icarus. Cool.
Ann Bryson flew out on a ship called the Icarus. Can you track its movements?
No. The Reapers have disrupted civilian comm buoys. But we might learn more if we find the ship's specifications.
Those bastards. Those metal bastards. Scope?
Any idea if Project Scarab involved Element Zero?
Unlikely. We may learn more from the Project Requisitions Locker.
Creature sightings.
Any correlation between Project Scarab and these unexplained creature sightings?
Not beyond Leviathan itself.
It's like we're looking for the Loch Ness Monster or Bigfoot or something.
There are specifications for several ships here. We need to find the Icarus.
Well, that's the Icarus. What if I search these other ones? Galu? Galdu?
Which ship am I looking for again?
The Icarus.
Which ship again?
We are looking for the Icarus.
Sure it's not New Orleans?
Which ship am I looking for again?
The Icarus.
Oh, this one?
The Icarus. Here we go.
The ship has enhanced electrostatic discharge cells. They facilitate long-range FTL travel.
So they jumped to the Pylos Nebula by mass relay, then flew to another system.
Mm.
Yes. Otherwise, they would have chartered a less expensive ship.
Okay, we can rule out the relay system.
Cool. Filter added. Oh, we can look at this thing now. Sovereign fragment.
The Reapers. Let's hope we find Ann before they do.
That's what that is, sovereign fragment. Anything else around here before I move on? Locker. Ah.
The locker is secure. We must locate an access card to open it.
In this drawer? PDA.
Access card for the requisitions locker?
Yes. According to records, it was last used by Ann Bryson to obtain equipment for Project Scarab.
Did we find the card?
Let's see what Ann Bryson requisitioned for Project Scarab.
Look at all these goodies. We got an assault rifle, Omniblade. Missing equipment.
Water recycling equipment.
Equipment.
Didn't take breathing masks.
Based on what Ann Bryson did or did not requisition, the dig site was arid, but habitable.
Get me a filter for systems with compatible planets.
We're really good at figuring this crap out, huh? Equipment activate.
Based on the search data, it is one of these two systems.
Oh, what systems are we looking at?
Based on the data, only one system remains a viable possibility.
Good. Let's go get Ann Bryson.
We're so smart. See how smart we are? Oh wait, blackout crimes?
What about criminal activity in the Pylos Nebula?
Because the area is part of the Attican Traverse, criminal reports are unreliable at best.
Okay, well that's alright, we already found it. Let's go. Please, let me go. Let's return to the Normandy. Bloop. Gotta head for the Pylos Nebula. Some system in there. Any messages before we just head there? Nope. Alright, let's go. I like those little looking for clues things with Edie, that's pretty neat. Over here. Pylos Nebula, scan dig site. Let's hope I can get some fuel. I mean, we are close to full. I just like to be completely full. Look at this little red star. So in the Narif system, we need to go to Zaharan, but there's also Dorada. Dorada sounds familiar. Isal. Isal is a standard hydrogen-helium gas giant. Though gas giants are known for their powerful magnetic fields, Isal's field is stronger than current models predict. Within the frost line of its solar system, where gas giants do not usually form, Isal is believed to have once been extrasolar. With no infrastructure to speak of, the Reapers have ignored Isal as a military target. Now, this is not Reaper occupied. I'm sure they'll be after us when we scan stuff anyway. Jonas. Jonas, a methane ammonia ice giant, is believed to be an extrasolar planet captured by its star. It was developed as a fuel depot serving the Pylos cluster. Eldfeld Ashland Energy had established a base on one of its moons to crack water ice into hydrogen and oxygen and skim helium-3 from its atmosphere. The Reapers destroyed both the base and the abandoned infrastructure, but not before triggering a trap, a crude nuclear device meant to catch them in its blast. From orbit, the Normandy sensors can pick out a sign that some waggish employee has left on the wreckage of the moon base, gone fishing. I hope that worked. I hope it caught him in the blast. Or is this trap still there? Destroyed both the base and infrastructure, but not before triggering a trap. Okay, so they triggered a trap, but how effective was it? I hope they got damaged big time.
Signal confirmed.
Cool. Oh my god. Some fuel? Yes, 300 units. We're full now. It was already full. Do we automatically get filled up when we go to the Citadel then? Because we had like 893 or something like that. Scan. Scanning an ice giant. What could be hidden on an ice giant? Not an ice giant, gas giant. Probe launched. Jovian dissertation. Ooh, neat. Wish you could find out what this stuff was without having to exit out and then walk all the way to the war assets. That's why I don't do that. Cool. 100% assets recovered. Let's go to Dorada first before we head on. Oh, especially since it's on the way. Makes sense. Big system. This little asteroid belt so close. That's that planet. Ciano. Ciano, named for an ancient Asari philosopher known for being a contrarian, orbits Dorada at a retrograde. It is believed to be an object that fell into the system millions of years ago from parts unknown. The outermost of Dorada's two asteroid belts is thought to have been a small planetoid that was broken up by Ciano's passage into the system. Ciano is formed of low-density rock and is tidally locked to Dorada. The same hemisphere always faces the star. There is evidence that a complex of artificial structures once existed in the north of the sunward-facing hemisphere, but they have been badly degraded by millennia of heat and radiation. Several bunkers of radioactive waste, apparently byproducts of primitive fission plants, have been discovered on the far side. The Reapers appear to have ignored Ciano, concentrating on systems with a higher population. Next planet. Second from the sun, Thanusi. Thanusi is a small, barren rock, though there is evidence that it once had an atmosphere of carbon dioxide, only trace amounts of krypton and xenon remain. Like Ciano, it is tidally locked to Dorada. Third, Canalis. Canalis is smaller than Earth, but has unusually high density. The high level of tectonic activity indicates that the density is caused by an abundance of radioactive materials in the core. These, combined with the planet's unusually high rate of spin, raise the planet's internal temperature and cause volcanism. While several companies performed mineral assays in the late 2170s, the world's geological instability precluded development. Zeth. Zeth is a common hydrogen-helium gas giant. An abundance of sulfur in the upper atmosphere gives it distinct yellow stripes. Short but sweet. Next is Sinius. And I didn't press that correctly. A standard hydrogen-helium gas giant, Sinius has more than 80 moons. That's even shorter. And our last planet, another gas giant, Viaressa. With an orbital period nearly 2 millennia long, the cold and distant Viaressa was actually missed in the initial Asari survey of the system. Only a follow-up mineral assay sent to Canalis by a Volus mining concern noticed its subtle movement across the stars. Viaressa is a methane ammonia ice giant circled by a retinue of deep frozen moons. Its remoteness makes it a popular drive discharge point for pirates working the Pylos Nebula cluster. In the last 2 years, several dozen ships have disappeared while passing through the Dorada system. As Pylos is currently unclaimed by any sovereign power, hey, you don't be saying that, the one who must not be named, Council naval patrols are few and far between. Thus far, none of the pirates responsible have been apprehended. Alright, so where do we think the goodies are? Because I'm not going to be able to scan this whole system. If I go here, we can scan all three. Yeah, I was wondering if that was going to happen. The Nusi? What about this one? What about here?
I found something.
Cool. Yeah, very slowly becoming aware of us. Because this isn't really an important system. Probe launched. Radiation shielding sheath. Cool. Getting some goodies. There's another asset, though, which is probably not on a planet. Should I just fly around, see if we can find it? I don't know where it is. Yeah, we're out.
Reapers eluded.
We still have to go back to two other systems and try to find the crap there. So there's one thing there, and I just don't know where it is. It's a heron. Alright. Estac? Estac was discovered by a joint Asari-Vorcha exploration team and abandoned shortly thereafter. The planet's light atmosphere of nitrogen and krypton is not overtly hostile to Vorcha, but its heat makes it uninhabitable except in expensive habitats. Its low density precludes the presence of many valuable minerals, and so settling the planet was deemed not worth the effort. Namakli. An arid but habitable planet, Namakli was briefly colonized by the Pyrena Corporation, a consortium of Asari colonists and socialized Vorcha laborers. After an economic downturn, however, many Asari left the planet, and the Vorcha population kept growing to the point where they bred faster than could be educated. Soon they turned violent and uncontrollable, and the colonies eventually self-destructed. Today, Namakli is a wasteland with little population, but Vorcha packs are scattered across the deserts. Settlers frequently run into these packs, discouraging colonization. The lack of complex biota and scarcity of profitable metals drove the last few proverbial nails into Namakli's coffin. No one has stepped forth in the past few years with the will, the funding, or the firepower to establish a permanent colony. We got no population information there. Azrahas. Azrahas is a hothouse planet rich in nitrogen, methane, and ethane. Similar to Namakli, it is metal poor. Additionally, it is suspected that few asteroid impacts have struck it over the millennia, precluding accessible deposits of common precious metals in the crust. Decrepit Asari orbital stations from scientific expeditions long ago circle the planet. None display signs of occupation. And finally, Rotesque. Like Rotesque. We're not sure where we're supposed to be going, right? Which planet? A methane-soaked gas giant, Rotesque, featured helium-3 collection machinery serving the colonists of Namakli, but it appears their kinetic barriers failed long ago due to neglect. The apparatus was destroyed by meteorites, probably originating in Rotesque's rings, creating one more hurdle for anyone trying to settle on Namakli. So here, but we don't know which planet.
Signal confirmed.
Begin scan. And my mouse keeps running off the pad with this. Here we go. Probe launched. Search successful. Scans have located a close grouping of environmentally shielded habitats and an active power source. Closer examination is required to confirm dig site presence.
We have located Ann Bryson's dig site.
Oh, goody. Let me just see if there's anything else in this system. There is. So far, Reapers are unaware. So we can just scan at will here. Probably just some fuel or something. Here we go. I was correct. 350 units. Enough to fill us up again. Yay! Alright, Namakli. Let's land. Kind of run up being Liara and Javik again. I'm sorry, you guys. I hope. I don't know. I'm just drinking. I don't want to keep bringing the same people over and over again, but I want to bring them. I'll mix it up, like, soon, guys. Maybe the next one I'll switch Liara out with Edie or something. So I'm curious. It automatically, right. Improve that to number 2, that's what I wanted to know. Yeah, I'm gonna keep everything the same. I got 6 points. I know I haven't used this, like, hardly at all recently, but we can upgrade charge. Give biotic charge a 25% chance of not triggering a cooldown, or increase barriers by an additional 50% after successful charge. Yeah, let's do that. We're full on charge. Next, we got flare as well. I'm not completely sure if I'm keeping Flare. I mean, I want to see what bonus power we can get with Javik, unless we've already seen it. I don't even know. Anyway. Liara. I don't use the warp ammo hardly ever. I'm going to save her points for pure bionic. I'm going to max that out, and then we'll see about these other two. And Javik. Lift grenade pull. That's limited by 4 amount of times, which is good. It seems pretty powerful, though, the grenade. Then again, we can increase by 2 here. Or the power duration. Let's increase this by 2. I'll try to use grenades with him a lot more. And that's it. Confirm.
I understand we have reports of an attack on a group of scientists.
More information?
Right. Edie, can you tell us anything else?
This is the main site of a series of excavations established under Dr. Garrett Bryson. Staff records confirm the project lead is his daughter, Anne.
Mm-hmm.
She has recently uncovered another artifact possibly linked to Leviathan.
Another one.
That discovery must have made this dig site a target.
Huh. Well, it's a lead.
Yes. An attack means we're on the right trail. And since Bryson's daughter is our only lead, our objective is clear. Cortez?
Nothing so far, Commander. If she's down there, she hasn't responded to our hails. Getting some strange signals, though. Give me a minute.
Uh-oh.
The artifact she uncovered may have caused additional problems. Who knows what we'll find?
Agreed. Take us in closer.
Copy that.
Ooh. They have freaking dragons here.
We have
pterodactyls?
Take us in.
Commander, on the landing platform.
Under attack by...
That's her.
Oh! Oh!